Welcome back. So let us consider the application of the optical fiber in point-to-point communication system. So in optical fiber communication, the optical signal or the pulses of light will be transmitted using optical fiber. And you know that the communication is based on the principle, transmission of the signal is based on the principle of total internal reflection. Right. So now most of the telecommunication companies, telecom companies nowadays using the optical fiber to transmit the telephone signal, internet data and TV signal, etc., cable TV signal, etc. Okay. So this is the basic block diagram of optical fiber communication system. So just a block diagram there. So let us consider the very simple use of the optical fiber communication in transmitting the voice of a telephone user. So now consider the telephone there. You know that the telephone has the two sections. One is the receiver section, it will be near to your ear, and transmitter section, it will be near to your mouth, right? So this voice will be converted into electrical signal. It will be in the form of analog electrical signal, okay, using a transducer. So voice will be converted into analog electrical signal. That means output of the telephone will be analog electrical signal. So this analog electrical signal will be directly fed to the coder, which converts analog electrical signal into binary electrical signal. I think you are familiar with the binary electrical signal, where only two states of the voltage will be there, like 1 and 0. So 0 stands for low voltage and 1 stands for high voltage. That means all the information will be converted into binary electrical signal. So this binary electrical signal will be the input data for optical transmitter. So this binary electrical signal will be directly fed to the optical transmitter, where optical transmitter consists of light sources like LED or laser diodes. Right. So this LED or laser diode convert binary electrical signal into pulses of light. So for example, so 1 means here the LED will be on, 0 means LED will be off. That I have shown here. So for 1, LED will be on, and for 0, LED will be off. That means so all the binary electrical signal will be converted into pulses of optical power. These pulses of optical power will be directly fed into the optical fiber. Okay, within the acceptance code, everything you understood there. So it will be transmitted through the optical fiber, since there is no loss of energy. So ultimately, after traveling hundreds of kilometers, so same intensity can reach the receiving end there. There is no loss of energy, but there is a loss of energy due to the attenuation that you already considered in the previous video there. So this pulses of optical power, that is light signal, so reach the receiving end now. So this light has to be converted into electrical signal, analog electrical signal once again. So this pulses of optical power, that is light, will be fed to the photodetector. Photodetector converts light into electrical signal. Since the input is in the pulsed form, the output of the photodetector also will be pulsed form, electrical signal, but it will be in the pulsed form, what you call binary electrical signal. Okay, so photodetector converts light into electrical energy, pulses of electrical energy, nothing but what? Binary electrical signal. In modern communication system where silica fiber is used, indium gallium arsenide photodiode will be used as a photodetector. Photodiode will be used as a photodetector, which converts light into electrical energy based on the principle of photovoltaic effect. So now light is converted into binary electrical signal. This binary electrical signal once again converted into analog electrical signal using a decoder. At this stage, if my device is able to process the binary electrical signal, so this remaining part is not required. Directly we can process this binary electrical signal. So if my device, a telephone, cannot process this binary electrical signal, it has to be converted into analog electrical signal. That's why a decoder is used. A coder converts analog electrical signal into binary electrical signal or digital signal, whereas decoder converts binary electrical signal into analog electrical signal once again there. So now again I got the information, that is the voice was the information. So voice is converted into analog electrical signal at the end there. So my telephone has a technology to convert analog electrical signal into voice once again. So that's how information that has been transmitted voice is reaching the receiving end, even though it traverses hundreds of kilometers there. So this is the basic application of point-to-point communication system using optical fiber. The point to be noted here is, if I want to transmit the signal over a long distance, hundreds of kilometers, because of the attenuation, somewhere in the middle, say for example 80 kilometer, 100 kilometer, something like that, okay, signal strength may be too weak. I may not be able to process the information there. So for that, I have to use the repeater. So repeater helps to enhance the weak signal and convert into strong signal. It increases the gain and compensate and overcome the attenuation there. So this is the application of the repeater. For every 80 kilometer or 100 kilometer, so we have to include a repeater which enhances the weak signal and convert into strong signal and enhances and overcome the attenuation there. Okay, so this is the basic application. So repeater plays a key role in increasing the strength of the signal and overcome the attenuation. Okay, so this is the simplest application of optical fiber in optical fiber point-to-point communication system. What are the applications of optical fiber? Need not write in the examination, but remember, what are the applications of optical fiber communication system? So large transmission capacity, information carrying capacity is very high in when compared to the metallic cable communication system where copper cables are used there. So a single fiber can carry a thousands of telephone channels, right? Information carrying capacity is very high. And small loss is very less. In case of copper cable communication system, you know that as the length increases, resistance also increases. So that's why, so loss will be more. In this case, length will be only around 0.2 decibels per kilometer. So that means without using the repeater, we can transmit the signal over a long distance. Signal is only 0.2 decibels per kilometer signal is lost in a single mode fiber. And low cost and lightweight. You know that the raw material is silica, sand it is, okay. So copper, but whereas in case of the copper cable communication system, where copper is the raw material, copper is a raw earth metal and it's expensive, okay. So now here, this is made up of silica, fiber, glass, right. So silica, sand, it is cheaply available at low cost. So low cost and lightweight, weight is very less compared to the copper cable communication system. These are the advantages, main advantages of the optical fiber communication. I'll stop here. So try to write this answer for this question. Explain point-to-point communication system using optical fiber. So write this block diagram, explain each part and explain the concept of repeaters, everything there. Thank you.